Okay, good, it worked this time. Oh man. Every now and then when I activate Steam, or not Steam, it's, can't talk already, Fraps, and I tell it to record, it, disables my microphone. Every now and then. Did that 3 times in a row. Anyway, we have had 2 amazing runs in a row, and I think that's probably going to end soon. Most likely. I'll play as the Bandit, because I haven't in a while. I haven't played as a bunch of these in a while. So I'll get to that, yeah. Bandit. Okay, let's do this. See how this goes. I firmly believe that in the last 2 runs it was the behemoth that kept me going longer than anything else, so who knows, maybe I'll get another behemoth. Meanwhile, the bandit just has this you know, exceptionally high fire rate, which is kinda great, kinda sorta, just a little bit. Only if you tap the button with the right timing, though. There we go. So, while I'm getting this run started... Oh, really? That's the first thing? Lame. While I'm getting this run started, I have a few things to talk about. I apologize for the lack of Project M videos. Part of that is because I go back and look at the old footage that I have saved up to upload, and quite honestly, it's terrible. Like, me and Aggie and Scott are just all really, really bad at it back then. That's not to say we're, like, infinitely better now. We're not experts or masters at this point, but we're definitely better, and it's so cringeworthy to go back and look at that old stuff that I just can't bring myself to upload any of it. It's just all that bad in my eyes. And we've been meaning to do more recording, but unfortunately that's a little bit easier said than done. Because for some reason our capture card decided to stop being compatible with the computer we were using to record. So, you know, whatever the hell's up with that. I just realized I still don't really know how to play as the bandit very well. Although I can tell it's going to involve a lot of getting away from these things. Gosh. Eh, look at that, spike strip actually being helpful. Okay. But, yeah, so that, I'm sorry, I'm probably, in the meantime, I'm gonna find something else to fill the... Good God. That was awful. I'm distracted by talking, I'm sorry. Try that again. I'll find... Interesting spawn. I'll find something else to fill the Tuesday-Thursday slot. I'll probably start another series of my own until I can play it more with them. Scott, actually, or you may recognize him by his tag in those, 2020 Luck. He has expressed interest in uploading Project M videos of his own, or at least Smash Bros. In general, onto his channel, which he hopes to get up and running soon. So, Project M won't... Our RPM stuff won't be exclusive to me anymore. Soon as we're actually able to record again, anyway. At any rate. Which means I definitely want to find something else to fill the slot. I'm not sure what yet, but I'll find something. That's basically how I'm thinking of it. I've realized that part of my problem with dying so early in these runs is that I don't spend enough time farming in the early game. Or I could just get an infusion right off the bat. That's cool too. But, yeah, so that's that. Project M is still gonna be a thing. I might drop down... I mean, I was already gonna drop down 2 a week, so I could probably still do that and justify it. Depending on how much footage we actually are able to record. For now, it's along the lines of we'll see. Basically. What? Grants massive life on hit for 10 seconds. Okay, so that's what that thing does. But, yeah, so that's one of the 2 things that I needed to talk about. Hello, jellyfish. The other thing is that I will be, missing my weekly live stream on Saturday this week, which will be tomorrow by the time you see this video, and I apologize for that, but, Aggie and I are going to a tournament over at Washington State University, where we live relatively nearby, which lasts the whole day. It's a Project M tournament. Well, Smash Bros. It's Project M and Brawl. I don't think he'll be doing the Brawl tournament because he hates Brawl nowadays, but I will be. And because of that, obviously I'm gonna have to miss the live stream. That's unfortunate, but, you know, it's what it is. I might see if I can stream on Sunday, so watch out for that, right? But, yeah. And, yeah, I think that's all I really had to talk about. Oh, Wisp. I want to kill you because you give me money. I really hope the teleporter wasn't up on that terrace up there. Terrace? I wonder if that is considered a terrace. Welcome to Windless Zephyrs. Subscribe if you like meandering thoughts about linguistics. There are so many chests around. This is nuts. Shame I won't be able to get most of them, but... well, many of them? There's a teleporter, at least. Hopefully I don't die a horrible, miserable death again. Colossus! Hey, that's cool. Colossus is relatively much easier to defeat, and it's down here, too. Interesting. Well, hey, at least as the bandit, I can just chill off to the side and keep shooting. Until things appear to murder my face, of course, that is what happens. That's okay. Those Lemurians are potentially a problem. I'm gonna have to use the, I think it's called Flash Bomb. The second skill, the little explodey thing. I'm gonna have to use that a lot. I mean, it's the only really good crowd control option that the bandit has. Which is okay. And apparently this use item, which is, as necessary, I'll get some massive life regen. Can you give me something good? Ooh, crit chance. I'm okay with that. I might as well, you know, I probably should actually talk about the items that I have right now. So, let's see. In order, from left to right, if you look on the left side of the screen, you can see the items I currently have. In order... that is not healing me as much as I thought it would. There's Infusion, which gives me a permanent health increase or upgrade every time I kill an enemy. So, I get one extra health added to my overall health permanently every time I kill something. It's pretty sweet. Bitterroot is just a flat 8% HP increase. That's all it is. Not a particularly useful item, but it's cool though. And let's see, I got apparently two spike strips when I wasn't looking. Every time I get hit, it drops a spike strip that slows enemies when they walk over it. Which is not exceptionally useful, really. It's probably one of the worst items in the game. TB. CH? I don't think that's an expression that people use. It makes sense to my brain, though, to be completely honest. Okay, let's see if... I think with the use item active, I might be able to just chill here, and yeah, this is fine. Okay, that takes care of all them. There's a whole bunch of golems right there. Yes? Yes! That was completely unnecessary. Let's see, Lensmaker's Glasses is, a crit chance increase by 10%, I think, and then Energy Cell increases my attack speed when I'm at lower health. Okay. So, the bandit works in a way, in an interesting way. Crowd control is very difficult with the bandit, but handling any single enemy like this thing is exceptionally easy. I'm a little bit behind time right now, but that's okay. I'm gonna go back and snag some of the items I saw around here. Let's see. Toxic Centipede. Okay. Does damage when I walk over an enemy. Hangs around, damage over time, that sort of stuff. I saw a shop over here with a soldier's syringe that interests me greatly because attack speed buffs with the bandit are very useful, given that the bandit's attack speed is determined by how quickly you hit the button. You hit the attack button. I mean, sort of. It works that way, kind of. I heard, this is well before my time playing this game, but I heard that originally the bandit was extremely broken because you could fire basically nonstop if you hit the button hard enough. Or fast enough, not hard enough. They have since nerfed it, so the max fire rate is what you've seen me doing. It's just, you have to get the rhythm down, really. That's all it is at this point. It's still an exceptionally high fire rate. Especially at, like, starting levels. And 7 minutes down after the first, finishing the first stage, that's not particularly exceptional, but we'll see. I mean, I had such great luck in the last two runs, last two episodes, not runs, episodes, that I have high hopes for this. High hopes, whether or not they are, you know, justified, or accurate, or anything of the sort, that doesn't concern me too much. Okay. I have this single little bitty attack drone, which is just casually killing things for me. Thank you, buddy. Okay, it's not over there, so moving on. Can't afford that, and I'm probably not going to bother. I want to find the teleporter and get out of this stage as quickly as possible. If the teleporter is right down there where I just walked over, I ain't going to be too happy. I just noticed the bandit's hat flies off his head a little bit when he jumps. Look at that. That's adorable. Wait. No, that's not adorable. The bandit is a rough and tough, rumble, grumble type of person, I think. Oh, man. I really wish I was able to record during the times of day when I'm less dead. Sorry about that. I mean, school is a thing, work is a thing, etc., etc. Okay. I am already afraid, although the Ancient Wisp is not that hard to deal with. If you do it right. And by that I mean if jellyfish stop being a thing. Okay, this is already really frightening. Okay, this use item is not going to keep me safe from all these parents. But fortunately for me, I can turn invisible for an amount of time. All the enemies will charge after me, which is okay. I don't mind. I think for now my best bet is probably just going to be to keep running. Keep running, being invisible. Oh, my drone's dead. That's okay. Does not concern me that much. The jellyfish, I think, are what frighten me most. That's not very helpful. Those are the only things that can hit me, like, up on these ladders, for example. Bitches can't see me! Okay, oh god, oh god. 8 health, 7 health, Jesus. What killed me? What was it this time? You goddamn freaking, what was it? What was it? It was a parent. The thing's hitbox, wait, a parent? They weren't even attacking. Lame. Try again. I am dissatisfied, I am very dissatisfied. That's annoying. So maybe I've determined that I am better at this game with the Huntress and the Mercenary than I am with the Bandit. Or maybe the Bandit's just not as good. I don't know. Tough choice. Who knows, really. I suppose someone could, like, sit down and calculate average DPS for each character and how well crowd control works. Or they could realize how big of a nerd they are and then remember that the Huntress can kite and the Mercenary has like a crap ton of invincibility frames. Anyway, keep moving. Hey, there's that one use item again. I'm not going to get it though, because I would much rather have the soldier's syringe from that little spot right, that little shop right there. This time, though, I want to find the teleporter as quickly as I can, and then while it's going, I'll go back and get this loot and stuff. I do realize what I recognize what I said earlier about having to, like, needing to farm a bit more than I usually do. I get that. Doesn't mean I'm going to, but I probably should. And I'm just over here hiccuping. Good plan, right? No, you're not dead. Now you're dead. Okay, there's a lot of loot around here, and there's no teleporter down here. That's disappointing. I'll take random. It gives me a golden gun. Okay. Interesting. So now I do more damage the more money I have. That's what that little bar next to my character represents, how much money I have. And, you know, the higher that bar is, the more damage I do, basically. Do I want to stay around here and farm for this thing? No, I don't. I mean, I'd love to, but this is monsoon, so it's probably a bad idea. Something to that effect, anywho. That means the only place left for the teleporter is in the upper left area, which is fine. That's kind of where I expected I'd find it anyway. That's where it usually... Oh, that's a lot of jellyfish. I'm gonna see about killing these things before I do teleporter stuff. Monster Tooth. That would have been exceptionally useful last time. So now I heal on kill. Or rather, I kill an enemy and I am healed. An amount. 10, specifically. For now, at least, it's 10. So I'm gonna activate this. That is a Colossus. So there's this really nifty thing I can do up here where I can just chill right here. Pretty sure the Colossus can't get to me from there. And I can still hit those enemies with the flash bomb or grenade or whatever it is. Colossal Knurl, okay. If memory serves correctly, that is a major defense boost. Like, it's a health buff, health regen buff. Oh, Jesus, this is really scary, so I'm gonna take this and get out. Am I actually hitting something? I hope I'm hitting something right now. Well, now I know I am. I want to go down and get that 50 chest, even though it may be a bad idea. Actually, that is a really bad idea. I'm not doing it. Instead, I'm going to go for all of the loot that I saw off in this direction. Kill some Lemurians and jellyfish and whatnot along the way. Make sure I have enough money. And apparently this wisp. Sure, why not? Okay, so there's a 25 chest here. Crit chance, okay. That's cool. Play this once. Sprouting egg, so if I don't get hit for 7 seconds, I start healing faster. And then a golem somehow manages to find its way up here. Good job, buddy. You earned the right to attempt to murder me. I'm only gonna play that once. Okay, let's go back and look for more loot, shall we? Unfortunately, I'm putting myself well behind the amount of time I should be spending again. But, okay. So of these items here, I want this thing, which is a first aid kit, which heals me, I think, 4 seconds after I'm hit. For 10, something like that. Potentially very useful. Attack speed increase, and I think that's all the time I have to spend here. 28, 47. I think I can only afford to play this once. Yeah. Mysterious Vial is just a flat health regeneration increase. Or rather, it increases the rate of health regeneration, I should specify, because those are very different. I mean, it's not like it's regenerating 2 per whatever tick. What it's doing is decreasing the length of the tick. And I only use the term tick because I play Minecraft. Where everything is measured in ticks. Game tick, redstone tick, TikTok, etc., etc. Look at that very significant health attack speed increase. I love it. I have no reason to open that, but I'm going to. Okay. I am actually gonna go check over here for some more loot. There's a shop where every single shop item is in one spot, which means I think if I activate it, I'll get one of them, and I don't know which. Take random. I'll buy this drone, another first aid kit, and I'm getting out of here. No, I'm not! I can afford the shop, never mind! Let's see what it gives me. What are you gonna give me? It gave me Lensmaker's glasses, okay. So I've got three of those after the first stage. Damn, that's pretty sweet. I think that's just a straight 30% crit chance boost. I'm gonna start by opening this. It would help if I could actually do things. Three little bitty containers already. Just see about killing some stuff along the way. Get at least some funds going. Alright. There's a big chest. Given where I spawned, I think it's possible the teleporter could be down here, so I am going to check. It's unlikely, but possible. No. Nope. Okay, moving on. I cannot afford that chest yet, but I think if I take out the spitter here, and maybe this imp too. There we go, I can afford this thing down here. Life savings, gain gold over time, it's not very good. I mean, it goes up so slowly. 60, 61, 62, hardly anything, probably not worth it. I don't actually know what that does. I'll play that once more because I'm insane. I think what that does is it increases your attack rate for 8 seconds or something like that. I am not completely certain, unfortunately. And I don't really feel a need to be like super certain about what all the use items do in this game because I don't use most of them. Like, I know what is and isn't good, and that's all that I ever get. I can totally afford this. ATG missile mark 1, chance to fire a missile when I hit an enemy, barbed wire damages enemies nearby. There's the teleporter. Hopefully I can get this teleporter event over with quickly enough. Magma worm. The bandit potentially has difficulty handling a magma worm. Okay. I'm taking more damage than I'd like. But I think if I just chill on this rope, jump out occasionally, and fire one of the grenades, I should whittle it down pretty quickly. I guess I can shoot it a couple times too, for good measure, right? Yeah, I'll take out the magma worm pretty quickly here, doing this. One more pass and it'll be dead. I'm surprised no missile elites have spawned yet. Burning Witness. I'm honestly not 100% certain what this does. I have no reason to buy the drone back. Oh, Jesus. Too many mushrooms! Oh, God! Get out! Okay, that is a mass of enemies I would really rather not attempt to deal with just yet. I feel safer against a bunch of Lemurians, which is not apparently justified. Okay, that's it, I'm out. Maybe if I just hang out here for a bit and let my health regenerate. This is not good. I can totally hit things from here. Not that that has very much significance or meaning. My health isn't even regenerating very quickly. Maybe if I do this, and then quickly travel down this direction. Okay, this is the layout where there's a single discounted large chest right here, which I still cannot afford. Okay. I believe the Burning Witness item causes me to track fire and increases my movement speed when I kill an enemy. Yeah, so there's tracking fire. The question, of course, remains, at this point, am I faster? The answer is, sauerkraut, because I don't know. Okay. I'm gonna lure them all this way, go invisible, go on the other side. In a moment. Go this direction as quickly as I can. Activate this and start firing and doing double damage. That should take out most of the enemies down in this little grouping. Granted, there is this mushroom that is adjacent to me, which is now dead, thankfully. You know, just like the last two runs, I feel like a behemoth would really be the clincher here. I just feel like that would really make this a viable run. Not that I can do anything about that. I can't exactly will a behemoth into existence. Not in a game with this much RNG. Ah, whatever. I unfortunately predict that I'm going to die, and that's okay. Hello, teleporting enemies. Barbed wire still hurts them when I'm invisible. Haha, sucks to be you guys. Urg. I greatly dislike how much damage just these enemies alone are dealing. This is irritating. It's the mushrooms, I tell ya. Those damn things are doing a lot of damage. I want to get my health regen on a little bit again. Sprouting egg should kick in momentarily. There it goes. Right, containers have healing in them. More teleporting mobs, yay! That's okay. It's really not. Oh gosh. Honestly, I could just keep leading them back and forth and trailing fire. Or not. Sorry, I don't have the fireman's boots. What am I talking about? Okay. That is the worst thing I have seen in a while. I'm gonna handle this by going immediately invisible, and then going this way. I'm gonna go check on this big chest here, see if it gives me anything that will save me. Tough times, that's cool. That's not gonna carry me through that huge-ass fight that's coming up shortly, but A 14% damage reduction is nice. Damage intake reduction, sorry. I always forget, I gotta specify these things, you know? Man, I am so looking forward to getting a new computer. One that can actually run this game at its, you know, full potential. I'm getting so sick of 30 frames, of 20, look at this, 20, 25, 29. So sick of this. Okay. I think my next plan of action is going to be to do this. And actually go up here, because I remember there's a big chest up this way. Oh, right, there's all these things, too. Something good. Tesla coil! Oh, god, yes. That may very well be what saves me here. So Tesla coil has a chance to electrocute enemies that are nearby, and I'm pretty sure it is active while I'm invisible. So I may have to just straight up rely on doing that. On barbed wire, trailing fire, and Tesla coils. My Tesla coil. Oh yes, look at this. That is exactly the item I needed. Aw, yeah. Look at that, all these enemies are melting. This is wonderful. I may get out of this alive yet. And I'll just buy this thing back again, because I can. It's like my friend at this point. Okay, the shattered mirror has worn off, but this is a thing that I can do. Look at this. I'm not even doing anything, and these enemies are just all dying. Yes, good. This is excellent. Seriously, that is just... That right there is gonna save me. Run back and forth, and kill things. Hell, I don't even need to do that now. Oh no, they killed my drone again! You jerks. Fine, I'll buy it back. And you know what? I'm getting out of here. Alright. I still have particularly low hopes for this run, but it's not impossible now. It's not impossible. Which is all I really need to hear, you know? Which I apparently like to say a lot. Hello, sand crab. I'm just going to chill over here, and you're going to die. Eventually. Yes, I know there are claymen spawning here. No, I don't care. Okay, then you're going to fall down here. I am going to kill these things, even though it's probably a bad idea. Although, of course, as usual, it stands that I may just up and run if I feel I need to. And I'm not buying that drone back again. Hell no. I will absolutely open this because there's some healing involved. A little bit of money wouldn't hurt. I'm gonna have to, again, hurry to the best of my ability. Do what I can anyway. There's a big chest, which I will be able to afford very soon. What's the matter? You can't hit me from there? Yeah, dummies. Alright, what you gonna give me? It gave me the plasma chain. Interesting. Ooh, the teleporter. Good. Which spawned a Colossus. And I think that flash means there's also a Wandering Vagrant. Which shouldn't be a problem. The Wandering Vagrant can be annoying, but I don't predict it will be. So long as you just keep moving, it's completely harmless, basically. Alright, stuff is happening. So far, it's nothing I can't handle. There are two big chests up here. I'm gonna get that whole Tesla coil barbed wire tracking fire thing going. Alright. With those three items, I think I actually have a fairly good amount of crowd control options right now. Which, as I've said before, is one of the bandits' biggest weaknesses, is crowd control. Granted, I'm not like in any spectacular position when it comes to handling these crowds, but I'm certainly, with the Tesla coil, much better off than I was before. What's this thing got? Ooh, thallium. Interesting. I'm not sure how well I'm going to be able to use that, but it's still pretty sweet. Has a chance to slow enemies on hit and deal damage over time. Okay. While I'm invisible, get some damage in there and then run. Good God, run. There's just way too much going on over there right now. I gotta get out. I'll check this chest and see if there's anything useful. Slow enemies on hit? Not the worst. Oh, geez. Right, whorls can slow you, I forgot. Alright, running again. Well, no, I don't think they can slow you, I think they do slow you on hit. Okay, plasma chain triggered, so I need to start moving away and see what kind of damage it can do. I'm not sure how, but I just took damage somewhere in that whole fray situation thingy. That wandering vagrant is still a thing. Which, while it's not particularly concerning, it is still a concern. Alright, the timer stopped tracking, so... or stopped counting. So I can start worrying more on killing these things, all these mobs. And less on running in fear. I think it's barbed wire that was actually hitting the Colossus right there. Fancy that. All this passive damage I can deal is so nice. Alright. There is no Acrid. Another golden gun. I think that just, yeah, that just decreases the amount of money that I have to have before the damage increases actually start becoming significant. I'm not sure exactly how much it changes. I think it's about half, maybe. Yeah, barbed wire totally hits that thing. So I could just chill like that if I wanted. Of course I won't, because that would be wasting way too much time. Yeah, you know what? It's gonna be pretty slow going for some parts. I mean, slower than it already has been. Slower, like more slow than just the technical issues. Slower than just the technical issues. Whorl, you do not in any way intimidate me. Alright, I know there's a huge mass of enemies over here still. Apparently, it's almost entirely sand crabs. Which is not in any way a problem. I was mistaken. I was a little bit more afraid there. I think I'm making up some of the time I've lost in previous stages in this particular one. Of course, that's no guarantee of anything good, but we'll see. Tracking fire, and also running. I just realized that the plasma chain is also exceptional crowd control if it activates. Explorer's key. Interesting, but I don't think I'm going to be able to use that. Oh, there's enemies over there. Seriously? Fine, make me loop around. Gosh. Oh, there's enemy over here. Yeah, okay, you're dead. And I remember there's a single small chest over here, so I'm going to go snag that. I don't need that. I like what I have a lot more. Although at the same time, that would be extremely useful. But I don't think it's going to be useful enough, I guess, is the thing. And apparently I'm buying this thing back again. I mean, the only reason I ever bother getting these Mark 1 attack drones is because I have no other use for the money when I'm done with everything on the stage. So, like, what else am I supposed to do? Give it away to charity? Well, there are no charities on this godforsaken planet that this game takes place. Because nobody wants to end their sentence with a preposition, right? And just keep falling. Magma barracks, lovely. Am I ever, like, when was the last time I even saw the hive cluster? It's been so long. In recent memory, anyway. I probably have been there and just don't recall. Because paying attention to things is hard. That is such a lucky teleporter spawn. And it even gave me a toxic beast. I am totally okay with that. Because fortunately for me, toxic beasts are very easy to kill. Especially one that apparently does not want to run back and forth at all. Oh well. Keep going with this. I remember there's a challenge you do with the bandit, which is kill a boss with lights out, which is the bandit's last ability, the fourth one. If I recall, it does 600% times 600% of your regular attack damage, and if you kill an enemy with it, it will reset all of your cooldowns. I am so surprised that I can just kind of sit here and live. I wonder what it is that's keeping me alive right now. Let's see, I got a monster tooth, two med kits. Not very much, come to think of it. Okay. I apparently spoke a little bit too soon there. That's okay. This is still a thing that I can do. These evolved Lemurians are going to kill me. I can feel it. Or maybe the mechanical spiders will, who knows? Damn it. I missed. Ah, shit. I was so close to killing the toxic beast. I recognized what was happening there. I was going to die. It was inevitable. But I was so close to getting the toxic beast with the, lights out. Damn. Well, that's gonna do it for the gameplay. I just want to quickly take a look at this. Unless I already did it. Did I already do it? Find the bloated... Oh, right, that was a thing. Bandit. Oh, I already did. Hmm. Okay. Well, I've got a lot more stuff here to do. Let's see. Survive a boss with less than 20% health. That could be very difficult. Die 50 times again. Not too partial to that. Drown 20 whirls. That's dumb. I could probably do both of these if I play my cards just right. Honestly, for stay above 70% health for 25 minutes, I could really just, like, chill in one spot after the teleporter event is done and let it run. Probably. Defeat the Legendary Wisp. I've never even seen a Legendary Wisp. Ever. In all my time playing this game. Detonate 15 Bounding Mines within 5 seconds. That's actually pretty easy. Reach level 10 without getting hurt more than once. As the Miner... Jesus. And then kill, Okay, that's not surprising. Well, I apparently have a long ways to go before I've, I'm at about 75%. This is only episode, 15? 16? I don't pay attention to these things very well. Anyway, that's gonna do it for now. Thanks for watching, and ostensibly, I will see you next time. Clearly, I've got Smash Bros. On the brain. There's a tournament in 2 days. How can I not have it on my brain? I'm so excited. It's gonna be great. Anyway, that's it. That's all. Thanks for watching. See you around. Bye. Etc. Etc. You get the idea.